Now I'm discussing one of the example in microprocessor initiated operation, that is memory read operation. When you talk about memory read operation, which is to read the data from memory, to read the data from memory, we should know how the data is to be read from memory. For that, already we discussed about the buses, three different buses are there. Address bus, data bus, and control bus. These buses are used to do all these operations. So here, memory read operation means, first of all, we should know the address. We should know means the processor should know the address from where the data is to be taken. So here, address bus is there to identify that address. So address bus will identify that, but the processor has to give the address to the address bus, then only the processor, the data bus can identify the address. So first, to read the data from memory, first of all, the 16-bit address is to be identified by the processor, and that 16-bit address from the processor is to be placed on the address bus. That is the first step is to be followed. The 16-bit address is to be placed on the address bus. As I said, the address bus starts from A0 through A15. The entire address carries through that address bus. And as soon as the address bus is placed on the address bus, it will say and go to the memory, and it will activate that memory chip. Once the address is enabled, next step is to identify which is the operation to be done. So for that, the operation to, for this example, the operation to be done is memory read operation. So to do this memory read operation, second step is to send the memory read control signal by using control bus. So there comes the use of control bus. Control bus is to send the any one of the control signal through that line. So MPU sends, that is your processor sends memory read control line through the control signal. The memory read control signal is generated inside the processor, and it will be sent through the control signal. And control, which is sent through the control bus, and as soon as the control signal is received by the memory, the memory cell is the particular memory cell which is addressed by using the address bus is enabled, and now we can transfer the data from memory to the processor. So for that, there comes the next usage of next bus, that is the data bus. So the third step is placing the 8-bit data which is stored already in the memory on the data bus. And finally, the data bus carries the those 8-bit data and send to the processor. And processor will execute that. So here is the diagram for memory read operation. So here is a processor, that is MPU, 8085 MPU, and there are many MPUs, any MPU you can use, that is any processor you can connect with memory to communicate with between processor and memory. Here I am using 8085 as a processor. In 8085, 16-bit address bus and 8-bit data bus, and size of address bus and data bus varies with the processor. Now, the first step, I have told you, MPU places 16-bit address on the data bus. There you can see the 16-bit address bus that is placed in the data bus, and that 16-bit address bus is connected to the memory chip. It is mentioned there. And there is a memory decoder section in the memory chip which will decode the address, whatever address sent through the address bus, that will be decoded, and it will select that particular chip based on the address. That particular memory chip is memory cell is selected, and after selecting that memory cell, Next comes the last the last line, single line, which is the control bus. There is a control signal known as memory read control signal, MEMR bar. It is represented. Why it's represented like that is, which is an active low signal. When you say about active low signal, that particular signal or that particular line is activated when a low pulse comes through that. So whenever a low pulse comes through that, the that particular memory cell is enabled. So here active low memory read control signal comes, the memory cell in that memory chip is enabled, that is addressed by using the 16 bit address. After enabling that, next step is to put the data which is there in that particular memory into data bus for further data manipulation. So that is to be placed as the third step. It is the memory chip places the data onto the data bus, and the data bus is a D0 through D7. The data comes through that data bus to the processor for further process. Inside the processor, there is a decoder section, decoder and execution section, which will decode the data. Why decoding is required means the data comes as hexadecimal numbers, but the processor understands only binary numbers. So this data is to be converted to binary format, that is the machine language, which is to be converted into machine language and finally executed. This is about the memory read operation.